Blackstone Audio presents The Immortal Crown, Saga of Kings, Book 1, by Kieth Merrill. This book is read by Tim Gerard Reynolds. To my 8 extraordinary children, some of whom will actually read this book and like it. And to Dagny, my best friend and finest fan and favourite critic, who loves everything I do. The seal is broken. The ancient evil is come again. The secret works of darkness rise. The immortal crown is blind. And that which was lost shall be found, to be gathered in the righteous hand, by the child of pure blood, by the strength of a sword he cannot hold, endowed with the powers of godliness, and returned to the crown of endless life, to evil or to good, in the age of chaos, and the saga of kings. Codices of the Navigator, 23. Prologue. Annum 1059, Age of Kandelarr, Old Bones Keep, Dominion Dragonfell. Jagged bits of bone tore flesh from Dracor's back. The birchwood pallet pinioned his tongue and was almost bitten through. I won't cry out. I must not scream. I will endure this agony in silence. Or die. The grim resolve pounded through the boy's head. I will not die. I will not die. The brute with the cat and nine tails lashed him again. Blood oozed from the mangled flesh and ran down the boy's legs. He was only 15 years old, but considered himself a man. He clenched his jaw tighter and closed his eyes, until his mind was a blackened void where he screamed in silence. I will not die. I will not die. The sorceress watched from the shadow of the wooden cowl that covered her head. She was encircled by the 13 magi of the Scarlet Council, who stood beneath the graven image of She-Dragon looming from the wall of the cavern. The sorceress's blood-red robes dragged on the floor. She was old and hunched, as if the lump on her back were a stone too heavy to carry. She stepped forward into the cold blue light of the winter moon that fell through the opening above. Burning faggots of yew wood smeared with suet cast a flicker of fire on her face. Her old bones and crippling pain made her limp with the awkward gait of an imp. Pallid skin stretched over a rack of twisted bones. Talismans and dead things hung from a string of twisted grass around her neck. A dragon curled in a black tattoo from the gnarled lump of her belly to the bony shoulders, where the tail wrapped around her neck and was lost in the wrinkles of her face. Her blackened, ink-stained flesh gave her the appearance of a gargoyle. She muttered a spell and willed the boy under the lash to endure in silence, to prove himself worthy to fulfill the archaic prophecy that echoed in her head. In the time of kings and the day of chaos, the seal is broken. The ancient mysteries arise. She-Dragon is blind and rages from the mountains. That which was lost shall be found. The eggs of stone forged in the breath of fire, gathered in the hand of might by the child of no man, who is worthy of the blood of the dragon, being purged by death and suffering in silent darkness, and, clustered in her claws, will rise immortal by the power of the ancient secret to rule all flesh. And rain for
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.